A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. Jesus addressed this parable to those who were convinced of their own righteousness and despised everyone else. Two people went up to the temple area to pray. One was a Pharisee and the other was a tax collector. The Pharisee took up his position and spoke this prayer to himself. O God, I thank you that I am not like the rest of humanity, greedy, dishonest, adulterers, or even like this tax collector. I fast twice a week, and I pay tithes on my whole income. But the tax collector stood off at a distance and would not even raise his eyes to heaven, but beat his breast and prayed, O God, be merciful to me, a sinner. I tell you, the latter went home justified, not the former. For whoever exalts himself will be humbled, and the one who humbles himself will be exalted. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Hello, brothers and sisters. Once again, the theme for the readings is about prayer. So the Lord is teaching us how to pray, not only teaching us our Father, but teaching us the right attitudes when we come before the Lord in prayer. And the readings for today, the theme is humility and prayer. And this is something that is super, super important for each one of us, that whenever we approach the Lord, we need to have an attitude of humility, which doesn't mean that we show ourselves sad or downcast or just putting dirt on ourselves, but it simply means that we need to acknowledge who we are and who He is, that He is the Creator and we are the creatures, that He is our Father, we are His children, that He is God and we are simply human beings, men and women, but very much beloved by the Lord. So the first reading gives us a beautiful, beautiful verse where He says, the one who serves God willingly is heard. He says, his petition reaches heaven. The prayer of the lowly pierces the clouds. It does not rest till it reaches its goal, nor will it withdraw till the Most High responds, judges justly and affirms the right, and the Lord will not delay. So here we see a promise that when we approach the Lord with a spirit of humility, acknowledging Him as God and we as His creatures and His beloved children, that the Lord will listen to our prayer. And this is it's a promise. It's a promise. And we have a Father who fulfills His promises. And then in the Psalm, it says the Lord hears the cry of the poor. This is, again, another promise. The Lord hears our cries. Now, sometimes if we get into this attitude of pride and we don't think that we need anything, much less anything from God, then, of course, we will close ourselves, close our lives, and close our hearts to receive God's blessings. But we need to acknowledge constantly that the Lord is God and we are not, so that we can open our hearts and our lives to receive the blessings of God. The Lord hears the cry of the poor. And of course, in the gospel, the Lord Jesus gives us the famous parable of the Pharisee and the tax collector who went to the temple to pray. And he does this contrast. When a person relies on his own righteousness, and in a sense has this attitude that because I do the right thing, because I live according to God's commandments, because I fulfill all the rules, therefore God owes me. And that is a very prideful attitude. We cannot show ourselves before the Lord pretending that He owes us because we are apparently fulfilling His commandments, then He has the obligation to bless us. And it is a very stark contrast between the Pharisee and the tax collector. Of course, the Pharisees were like the professional religious people in Jesus' times. And we see how this Pharisee, there's a cute detail in the reading when he says the Pharisee took up his position and spoke this prayer to himself. We can see here a hint that when we have a prideful attitude, we put ourselves in the place of God. The Pharisee was not praying to God. The Pharisee was praying to himself. And he placed himself in the place of God. And he started praising, you know, not praising God, but praising himself. So it's the trap of a person who is selfish and who is proud and who doesn't want to rely on God, but rely on his own works or his own justice, which is a delusion, really. A tax collector, on the other hand, in Jesus' time, tax collectors was like the worst scam of humanity. It was people who everybody despised because they were traitors to Israel, and they worked for the Romans who were oppressing Israel at the time, and they were also very corrupt. They would take bribes and they would extort people for money. And but we see this tax collector, how he goes up and he prays also. But he goes to the temple and he prays to God. And he has this attitude, which is very different from the attitude of the Pharisee. His attitude is that he acknowledges his need. He acknowledges his lack of righteousness. He acknowledges that he is a sinner. And this is the same attitude that we need to have before the Lord. That's why before, when we go to Mass, the first thing that we do during the liturgy is we acknowledge our sins. When the priest says, let us pause for a moment and think of our need for mercy and think of our need for God's forgiveness. So we think on our sins, we present ourselves before the Lord, first of all, as sinners, sinners in need of mercy. And then his prayer is very simple. Oh God, address to God, not address to myself. He said, oh God, be merciful to me, a sinner. I acknowledge God first, then I acknowledge my need, and then I confess that I am a sinner in need of mercy. And we see how the Lord says, he who humbles himself will be exalted, and he who exalts himself will be humbled. So when we present ourselves before the Lord, and we present ourselves in our misery, in our need, in our and all the things that we desire to receive from him, he will listen to our prayers. The prayer of the humble pierces the clouds. And indeed, the Lord listens and hears the cry of the poor. And brothers and sisters, it is good for us to be poor. It is good for us to be needy. It is even good for us to acknowledge that we are sinners. Because then, Dr. Ralph Martin says, then we qualify for divine welfare. We qualify to receive from God everything that we need. So brothers and sisters, I encourage you to approach the throne of mercy of God with great trust, because he loves us very much and he wants to give us everything that we need. Our prayers, he wants to listen to our prayers and he wants to answer our prayers. So we need to approach him in humility, acknowledging that God is God, that we are not God. God is God, but we are his creatures. We are his sheep. We are his children. We belong to him. And he, as a good father that he is, will provide for all of our needs, particularly for our need for mercy, our need for justification, and our need for eternal salvation and eternal life. God bless you, and please pray for me. I will pray for you as well. Arrivederci.